so trustworthy watching over me while I slept. You must replace him now, said Dracula. To watch over me, while I slept. How am I ever going to replace Pablo? It was your actions that caused this. But Saul lapsed back onto the bed. And looking at her, they could tell that she was human again. Luckily, she had just about healed, before the metamorphosis set in. Then they sat around. After tonight, you'll never see us again, said Dracula. It was a pleasure meeting you, all of you, said Kalila. Then Dracula and Kalila said goodbye to everyone and left, turning towards Dracula. Charlotte smiled and said thank you. Then Dracula said, I always knew there was something special about you. And that's why you're still alive. Well, slash, it's a long story, forget it, said Charlotte. Then she said, what is going to happen to the werewolf? Before I leave, I will take care of it. I will fill your lab's refrigerator with vials of her blood as well as my own. If you need more, you know how to contact me. And then her and Tescat left. Then Charlotte went home and opened the door to find Alex still asleep on the couch. She sat down beside him and snapped her fingers, saying, wake up. And Alex opened his eyes, and when he realized it was her, he said, Charlotte, oh thank God. I have just had the scariest dream, but for the life of me, I can't remember what it was. It was about cheese. I forgot. That's all right, said Charlotte. I'm sure you'll remember it. Besides, it was probably something you ate. Huh. Yeah, I'm sure you're right. One night while Charlotte was fast asleep, she woke up to find Mia and Abel, large as life, standing over her. Charlotte's eyes light up. Are you vampires now? Charlotte asked. Yes, said Ava. We're three amigos back together again for the last time. Yes, said Mia. There are rules. We can never revisit places we lived when we were human. It was one of the rules Kalila and Dracula gave us, said Ava. I'm so happy to see you, said Charlotte. What are your plans? Well, we both always wanted OTC Paris, said Ava smiling. Mia nodded, and then Charlotte smiled. Then they hugged, and then Charlotte opened her eyes and it was morning. And she wondered if it had been a dream or if they had really visited her in the night. She decided to believe that it had been real, and Ava and Mia were right this moment, lying on a beach in the Riviera, soaking up the moonlight and toasting each other to Charlotte, to Charlotte. As she quietly got out of bed, not wishing to wake up Alex. Charlotte was a brilliant chemist, biologist, and all-around scientist. Her IQ was so high that she lacked social skills and only had two real friends, Ava and Mia. And of course a boyfriend on the side, named Alex. She did not wish to disappear into her lab in order to avoid living. So she got a job as a bartender at night to improve her social skills. After her contact with vampires, she became a bee researcher and dedicated her life to finding solution to the virus within werewolves that could turn vampires back into humans. As a side result of that research, she discovered a way to reset a vampire's biological clock back to day one as a vampire, that she named Birinu. So she had the better of two worlds. Her life in the lab and her life outside of the lab. The end
of part one.